There's a variety of different scenarios where you're going to want your installers to expire, either after a certain date or after a certain amount of uses, or even a certain amount of days after installation. Let's go ahead and look at how Setup Factory 7 automates this process for us with just a few simple clicks. We'll go into the security link of the settings pane here in the expiration tab, and as you can see, we've got some different options here. We can expire by date or we can expire by count, and within those we have sub-options. First thing we'll do is we'll go ahead and click this create button over here to create a unique product identifier to identify this particular expiration process. We'll leave our contact information off, but you could include it by clicking that there. And again, as you can see, they're making use of session variables here to streamline the process. Let's start with a usage count expiration for demonstration. Now I've got both of these buttons clicked down here, these radio or checkboxes rather, and I've checked the limit to blank installs per user, and I've got it set to 1. Okay, so we're limiting it to 1 install per user, and we're going to abort if the registry is not writable, and we are going to display the number of uses left. Okay, let's go ahead and publish that and run it, and we'll go ahead and look at how that acts. Basically what it's going to do is expire that installer after 1 installation. So we'll go ahead and run our installer. As you can see, it notifies us that it's going to run 1 more time. We go ahead and we run it, and it's installed. But if we try to run that same installer again, you can see what happens. It gives us a warning, tells us that we can't do it, and then aborts. We can't proceed with the process. So that's how you can automatically expire after a certain amount of uses. Let's go back into our security expiration tab here, and we'll disable the enable usage count expiration down here, and instead we will enable the date expiration area up here. Okay, so we've got a few different options here. We can expire X amount of days after the setup is first run. We can expire X amount of days after the first, or after the setup was built rather, or we can use an absolute date. And again, we have an option here to display the number of days left that we can check or uncheck. I'm going to use the absolute date option here, and I'm going to set it to a date in the past so that we know that this is going to be expired. I'm going to create another unique product identifier by clicking on the create button, and I'm going to press OK and go ahead and publish this, and we'll take a look at how it works. And again, we're looking at just a couple simple demonstrations of this functionality, but you can really work with this and experiment and come up with some great stuff. As you can see here, it says that the setup has expired and will now abort. So it actually recognizes that this setup is an old installer that we don't want clients to be running, and so it doesn't proceed. If we went back into the same area and then we actually, for example, change this to, say, 2 days after build and create a new product identifier, press OK and go ahead and publish that, you'll see that it'll actually be OK. We'll be able to run it multiple times, but in another 2 days, and of course we're not going to wait 2 days and come back, but as you can see here, it runs fine, right? And if I run it again, it'll keep running as many times as I want, but in 48 hours this is going to expire. So anyway, that's some different expiration options that you can set up really, really fast in Setup Factory with just a couple of clicks, and I encourage you to come in here and try these out. This is a really great way to control your content and know what's getting out and when it's getting out. So if you're using stuff that is time sensitive, or if you're using stuff that is basically not meant to be used as an end product, but perhaps maybe a beta test or just a sample application, these usage count and date expiration features are really, really handy. And again, remember that when you're deploying new projects and you want them to expire, to go ahead and click this create button to make sure that each of the products that you're deploying has a unique product identifier to identify that expiration process with.